Okay. Show me.
Hi there, guys. Welcome back to the Dutch Sea Channel. Thank you very much for tuning in. And I've got an exciting box here. Well, exciting box. I'm excited. I'm excited about this box here. It is a very colorful box, as you can tell. And this video is mostly just a show and tell. It's not a review. I wanted to show you this, the content of this box, because it's, I think it's very special. That's nice, right? Something out of the ordinary. So this box contains a frame from Lumeniere, but also its paint job and a slight geometry change is from Schizo, one of the godfathers of FVV, obviously. And yeah, again, I'm excited to show you this here frame. And as you can tell, the frame itself is packaged in a nicely colored box as well. Very, very nice. So the box contains the Lumeniere QFV R2. And again, its geometry is a little different, this Schizo edition, and obviously the paint scheme. And this is the slammed version as well. So I think special in not only one, two or three ways. Very, very nice. Let's have a look what's in this box. All right, we are greeted by decals, stickers, always nice to get, Lumeniere stickers. We get one battery strap and, oh, it's a nice, oh, that's what anti-stick should feel like. Damn. Okay, Lumeniere strap, very, very nice, plain black. And actually, what I'll do is I'll take everything out of the box. That'll be easier and show you what we got. Alright guys, while I'm showing you these frame parts, I should add that I got this frame from a local store, FVV Racing Twente. And if you're not from the Netherlands, that sounds like gibberish, probably. Again, a local store, there's a link in the description. This video is not sponsored by them. I bought this frame with my own money. But, well, it's always good to support local stores as well, of course. Moving back to the frame, this is, let me see, what is this? This is the top plate over here. And all carbon fiber is hydro-dipped. This is hydro-dipped, so it's not painted. Hydro-dipped, and you can't see any of the carbon fiber anywhere. This is the bottom plate. Is it the bottom plate? Yeah, underneath this bottom plate, there will be a brace, this here brace. And as you can hopefully see, the bottom plate has press nuts in it already. And yeah, this bottom plate can support 30.5 by 30.5 stacks, but also 20 by 20. It'll probably be hard to see, but there are definitely 20 by 20 holes as well. And at the rear, we've got 30.5 by 30.5 mounts, but also 20 by 20. And from the looks of it, there's no mount for a third stack in the front. But this should do, right? Two mounting positions for full stacks. However, you should keep in mind that this frame is slammed. There is a normal version of this QAV R2 hydro dipped by Schizo or for Schizo with a normal height. This one is slammed. So I'm assuming you can only mount like two layers in this frame, which should be more than enough, right? With the two stick mounting positions. Okay, so bottom plate, brace, top plate. And then we've got this snake. Sausage snake of arms. Yeah, I'll take them out in a second, of course. But funny sausage snake. I've never seen packaging like this before. Okay, let me see. There are fasteners. A bag of a lot of fasteners, which are plain black. Yes, okay. And we've got a bag with accessories. Foam landing feet. And standoffs, black standoffs. And one thing I didn't really know, but this bag contains the FV camera mounts. And they're not TPU prints? No. But I was wondering if I needed to source or print camera mounts. But no, the frame actually does come with these mounts. The full height version has carbon fiber plates alongside the camera to mount your camera. But this one will have plastic. We'll see in a minute, of course, when I've built the frame. One thing you should keep in mind, if you want to mount your FV antenna to the rear of the frame, you will need to buy or print something yourself. The frame does not come with an antenna mount. Okay, so it comes with this nice, very, very nice Lumeniere strap. Thank you very much. One, not a spare. And you got some anti-slip mounting for your battery, which is black. It's a bit of a shame to cover up this nicely, well, it's not painted, but screen printed piece with a, yeah, should have been transparent maybe, would have been nice. Okay, the last thing you get in this box is two zip ties to maybe mount your antenna. Alrighty, even though this is not really a review, I should go ahead and do a quality inspection as well. Okay, so there's no burring at... No, there's no burring at all on any of the edges. No. Also, you can't even see any of the carbon fiber, which should result in my finger staying perfectly clean. And yeah, there's no carbon dust on any of these frame parts whatsoever, which makes this frame 100% clean. Very, very nice. And beveling or filleting of the edges, not so much actually. It's not like you'll cut yourself easily on these edges, but they aren't rounded off. Okay, this is not a budget frame. I think you should round off these edges a little bit. Yeah. Again, you won't cut yourself on these edges, they're not that sharp. So I guess, again, they used well-maintained tools, there's no burring. And that also leads to clean cuts, if you will. But a little bit of beveling, I really like that most times. So yeah, again, this is not a review, but I would have changed that. What I'll do next is I'll build the frame off screen and then I'll come back to you with my findings. Here we go. And there you have it. One schizo edition of the Lumeniere QFV R2 slammed. And it's a beauty, right? Doesn't this look gorgeous? I should also add that this is not a super duper new frame. Well, it's brand new to me, but it's not a new product. I simply wanted one. And I also wanted to show you this frame. Maybe you haven't seen anything like it yet. I think it's a joy to see. Very, very nice frame. Even though it's basically based on a slightly older designer frame. Also, I should add that this is a reasonably simple or basic frame design, right? Bottom plate, risers, top plate and arms and a brace. We've seen a lot of frames like that, which is not a bad thing. A reasonably straightforward frame, well, is easy to maintain, if you will. And well, this is the slammed version, and the stock QFV R2 is wider than it is long. This one, the schizo version, is a true X, meaning that it is as long as it is wide. We'll see the actual dimensions in a second. Also, while building it, there were two things that stood out. It is super duper stiff, really super duper stiff. Also, it doesn't feel very light. Yeah, we'll see the actual weight in a second. Okay, so the build is super duper easy, right? It's a relatively straightforward frame. Again, you get some rubber landing feet in case you want to use those. And you get a lot of spare screws. Well, spare, Maybe some of these are for motors. I'm not even sure. Some are for different stick configurations. You also get long stick risers, and I will probably end up using those to mount my stick. But again, you get a lot of spare screws, which is always nice. Now, let's see the dimensions of this frame. Okay, front to back. Let's see. We've got 17 centimeters or 170 millimeters. Left to right, we've got indeed exactly the same number, 170 millimeters. Again, true X. And that's again a difference from the normal, if you will, QVR2. Then these arms are, let me see, you can't see the ruler, I know, 4 millimeters in thickness. And square, we've got 240 millimeters. So left to front to right rear. A 240 millimeter frame, that makes it. So let's see its weight. Here comes the downfall of this frame. It really feels heavy. Here we go. 130 grams, which is okay. Oh, yeah, I was afraid it would be like 140 grams, but well, okay, 10 grams less. Anti-skid plate. Yeah, there we go. Oh, damn, that anti-skid plate is heavy. Huh. Okay, then the battery strap. And yeah, 145 grams. But again, this 130 grams. I do have the camera mount already on the quadcopter. So yeah, the bare frame is a little less, but still, this is not a light frame. Were you expecting a light frame? These arms are wider than we typically see on most current quadcopters. So yeah, it does feel super duper stiff though. Yeah, but still, it's not a light frame. Which is actually not really a bad thing. Well, maybe I would have liked it to be a little lighter, but I'm gonna use this here frame to test motors. These motors here. These are T motors, brand new Pacer motors. 2207.5. So they should definitely be a bit more powerful than, well, what I usually run, 2207 motors. And the frame being a little heavier, well, maybe that's again a good thing to test motors to see if they can actually cope with this setup. So that'll be coming up, and yeah, that has nothing to do with the actual frame, of course. But well, maybe you are interested. I will be reviewing these T motors shortly on this Lumineer frame, and hopefully they'll perform well. That's however for a future video. So guys, that is the QIVR2 from Lumineer Schizo Edition. Tell me what you think of this. You definitely pay a price for something premium like this and special. Is it worth it? Depends on what you're looking for, of course, but I definitely wanted this one in my collection. Super duper beautiful frame, in my humble opinion. Yeah, so again, it does come with these camera mounts for micro size cameras. At the rear, you'll have to figure out something yourself for the FV antenna. It does have holes over here for zip ties. Maybe you want to secure your FV antenna like that. I will probably be printing something to mount my FV antenna over here. We'll see. You will be seeing this frame again. Like I said, I will be reviewing those T motors on this frame. And review of those motors coming up. Let me know in the comment section below if you are interested in me doing specialty products like this. Maybe not value propositions at all. Yeah, maybe you are interested in things from the edge of the RC universe, if you will. Let me know in the comment section below again. Thank you very much for sticking around. Catch you on the next video. Bye bye.